I love my Flashforge Adventure preprint. Thank you so much for watching. Leave a comment down below and don't forget to subscribe.
I'm like, I think it's a yummy talking.
Got you. Oh, where was I? So in this video, I'm going to be talking about the Flashforge Adventure 3 and comparing it to the Flashforge Adventure 4. And I'll let you know which one I think you should probably purchase. So the Flashforge Adventure 3, when it came out, it was amazing. You know, it was a good price. It was at £365, roughly thereabouts. One of the key features that the Flashforge Adventure 3 had was it had a minimalist design, an enclosure, a detachable nozzle, a print bed size of 150 by 150, and also could print to a volume of 150 millimeters off the build plate itself. It also had a heated platform, a detachable plate as well, a filament detector and feeder, and also had a mini LCD display as well. Even after the Flashforge Adventure 3, Flashforge also released the Flashforge Adventure 3 Lite, which had, you know, a few bells and whistles removed, but you know, it was still at a great price and an amazing product for beginners as well. So when we compare this print of the Flashforge Adventure 3 to the Flashforge Adventure 4, what you find is that there's some significant upgrades, but it does come with a hefty price at £550. You can potentially find it cheaper, but it typically converts to pounds at £550. And at that price range, you know, it started to creep to someone that, you know, has had a previous 3D printer and now wants to potentially have something that has a few more bells and whistles to it. I wouldn't recommend it for beginners. I'd still always recommend the Flashforge Adventure 3 or the Lite version of it. But let's see, you know, what this products comes with. So getting into comparing the two, what you find is that the Flashforge Adventure 3 has a filament spool container of about 250 grams. So, you know, so it can fit within its case itself, a filament spool that, you know, weighs and is about 250 grams. But when you compare it to the new Flashforge Adventure 4, it can actually hold 1 kilogram worth of filament, which means you no longer need to continually have to change your filament mid-print, especially if you're doing quite a large and quite a dense 3D print, which is amazing. The second key feature is that the Flashforge Adventure 3 has, you know, a fan that, you know, blows the air out, which is quite nice. You know, it gets rid of all that fume potentially within the printer, but it doesn't have a filter. Whereas when you compare it to the new Flashforge Adventure 4, what feature it has now is that it actually has a HEPA filter, number 13, and that actually filters all the odor, all the dust particles, which is absolutely amazing, because as well as having a fan that actually blows the air out, it actually gets filtered so you don't smell all the odor while you're printing, or, you know, because quite a lot of people have the printers in their bedrooms potentially. So, you know, being able to filter all the odors and all the dust from the actual print itself is amazing. And the next feature that the Flashforge Adventure 4 has over the Flashforge Adventure 3 is that it's able to resume printing. So this is an amazing feature, because say if you had a power outage or some, you know, accidentally the plug was pulled out of the printer itself, the Flashforge Adventure 3, that's it. You start from scratch. It's dead. It can't, you know, resume the print. You have to start from scratch. Whereas with the Flashforge Adventure 4, now if the power goes out in the building or, you know, the plug comes out of the printer, it's able to just go resume print, and then you press resume and it will just continue printing from where it left off, which is amazing, especially if you're using 3D printers as a business. So potentially there's no longer wasted, you know, prints. Okay, so the next item, which, you know, I've probably already hinted at it, it has a bigger printing volume than the Flashforge Adventure 4. So it has a build volume of 220 by 220 by 220 millimeters in height as well, which is huge when you compare it to the Flashforge Adventure 3, which only has a build volume of 150 by 150 by 150 in height. So if you're keen on getting a printer that has that type of build volume, the Flashforge Adventure 4 is the one that you should go for. So the next key feature that Flashforge Adventure 4 has over the Flashforge Adventure 3 is that its build plate has been changed. So now it actually has a build plate in Flashforge Adventure 4 that actually runs on magnets. So what happens is that when you want to detach the build plate from the actual printer itself, you just literally tug at the magnets detach, and then you can bend your 3D print off. And then when you want to attach it again, you then lay it down on the print bed itself, and the magnets will reattach, which also acts as an automatic leveler. Whereas compared to the actual Flashforge Adventure 3, you actually have to slot in and out the actual build plate itself. And sometimes you might get some bowing to the plate itself. So you have to recalibrate to make sure it's all level. Whereas with the Flashforge Adventure 4, it actually minimizes the need to even recalibrate or do anything because it's all on magnets. So it keeps the build plate nice and straight and flat instead of kind of bowing. And the next thing, which, you know, seems quite obvious, the Flashforge Adventure 4 is a lot more bigger than the Flashforge Adventure 3. And that's just to cope with the bigger filament spool slot that it needs, and also the volume size that it now prints. Apart from those few points, the rest of the features are quite similar to what the Flashforge Adventure 3 has, which is a built-in camera able to connect to their flash printing software to actually be able to print. You know, so if you had an army of 3D printers, you're able to send one print to all of the printers at once. It has that feature as well. It also has the possibility to be able to detach the nozzle itself and swap it for a thinner nozzle or a larger nozzle mouth. It also has the possibility to be able to print loads of different material types as well. And that ties in with, it also has a heated bed, which can go up to 110 degrees. And just even from an aesthetic point of view, the Flashforge Adventure 4 is more black and stealthy, whereas the Adventure 3 has, you know, some white patterns on the side, you know, blue logo, and also some black patches all around it as well. And finally, what would I recommend anybody that's getting into 3D printing do? I would recommend potentially starting off with the Flashforge Adventure 3 Lite, which is actually the lower version of the Flashforge Adventure 3, so it goes just before it, and then you have the Flashforge Adventure 3 and then the Flashforge Adventure 4. And I'd recommend potentially, you know, once you kind of mastered 3D printing and getting into the world of 3D printing, you then potentially upgrade to the Flashforge Adventure 4, which, you know, comes with extra bells and whistles, and it will just be worth the price point of £550 at that point. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe down below, leave a comment, and let me know any other videos you would like me to do about the Flashforge Adventure 3. See you soon.